Our rivers continue to rise across the state. Now, Governor Mark Dayton has extended a state of emergency for the next 30 days.
Today, we know that he will tour some of the hardest hit areas around the state, starting in Delano at the Crow River. That's where we find our Catherine Johnson. She begins our team coverage this morning, Catherine.
Yeah, and Megan and Chris, good news to report from Delano here this morning. The National Weather Service is reporting that the Crow River here just may have reached its crest, and we want to give you a visual of that. What we're finding over here, you can see right next to the river, there's this tree, which actually shouldn't be in the river, but you can look at the watermark, the water line there. It's gone down a good 4 inches from its biggest height, and we know that water levels and crest projections are a moving, changing target. This could always change. We want to give you an aerial view from Chopper 5. We took this video yesterday. The Crow River here is now at major flood stage at just over 21 feet. But again, this should be it. The river is cresting, and now you can expect to start to watch it recede. Now, as you can see, it's going to take some time. Predictions say it'll be a week before these levels are below flood stage here in Delano. And that's exactly why the governor is looking to extend that state of emergency for another 30 days.
It's the best part of how Minnesotans respond to help one another in a time of crisis.
And Governor Dayton will be here in Delano at 9:30. He's going to be meeting with city officials. He's going to be meeting with emergency management teams, trying to figure out the next step, especially if these waters are not starting to recede. But again, it looks like the river may have crested here. Good news for the folks here in Delano. They've been living in sandbag heaven for the past week or so. Live in Delano, Catherine Johnson, 5 Eyewitness News.
A lot of people watching that very closely, Catherine. Well, this afternoon, we know that Governor Mark Dayton is scheduled to meet with emergency managers and local officials in Scott County to talk about the flooding there. Communities along the Minnesota River have been hit very hard, including the tiny town of Blakely, where nearly 500 people are still out of their homes this morning. Some are staying with friends and family. Others are living out of hotels.
I never had to be evacuated out of my own home. You know, it's kind of an odd feeling. You know, it really is. It's kind of scary. And it's where you feel comfortable. It's where you feel peaceful. And you're having that ripped away from you is not a very good feeling.
Right now, a lot of folks can't even get to their homes. Some roads are closed because they're underwater. Other roads are compromised due to mudslides or some of the buckled pavement. We did see from Chopper 5 at least one home is underwater. People we know will be escorted back in one at a time today to check on their homes, to get any belongings that they can. We're hearing that it could still be up to 2 weeks before they are allowed to go back permanently.
In St. Paul, all eyes are on the rising Mississippi River. It is already well above flood level.
Our Steve Patterson is live this morning there with a look at the latest. Steve, what are you seeing?
I tell you what, guys, it's really, I don't know. It's, you know, they say a picture is worth a thousand words. I hope video does the same, because as you look out there at the Harriet Island Pavilion, that kind of shows you just how invasive this water has become as the Mississippi is totally just spilled over here. Here's what we know. A state of emergency has been declared. And I suppose sort of the most disconcerting part of all of this is that, as we've been mentioning, the water is only going to continue to rise. You know, right now it's at 18 and a half feet. That's major flood stage. That's beyond that by about a foot and a half. And it's going to go up another foot and a half from where it is right now. So that's got a lot of people on edge. This whole game is really wait and watch, see where things go. I want to show you some more pictures just so you can get a little bit of perspective. You see that tree out there just totally surrounded by water, and it's just amazing as you look at things here and see just frankly water where it ought not be. We know that already $1.7 million has been spent here by the city of St. Paul in flood preparation and preparing for a lot of fixing that's going to have to take place afterwards. So what they're trying to make sure is that if federal government money does get freed up, that St. Paul will have a say in that, a stake in that. And that's going to be important because, again, it's going to crest on Thursday, but then it's going to take a while for it to recede. So this is something that a lot of people are going to have to be really patient with, especially here in St. Paul, guys.
Steve, just for you to get to your live location there, I know that there are a lot of roads that are closed in that area. Was that logistically tough for you? And are there a lot of people who are kind of looky-loos who are out just wanting to see the water like that?
You know, we had a lot of looky-loos yesterday at the Stillwater Lift Bridge. We haven't had that. We had a couple people jogging, but nobody down here really taking pictures. That being said, the other entrance to Harriet Island, where we had first looked to go, was blocked off. So you do have to get a little bit creative. As far as side streets and things like that, it was okay for us, but we know for a lot of people that are out there traveling, a lot of their normal routes just frankly aren't available to them right now.
All right, Steve, we'll watch that closely. Another foot and a half, we're thinking. Okay. Well, for the latest flood coverage, make sure you head to our website, kstp.com. You can find links to river levels, forecasts, road closures, park closures. It's a lot of information there, valuable information. Just click on the link tab there at the top of our homepage. New over.